paragraph of the Catechism of Catholic Church, which says, this is the first paragraph. Yes, let's read out.
God, infinitely perfect and blessed in
infinitely
himself.
Infinitely perfect.
And blessed in himself.
And blessed in himself.
In a plan of sheer goodness.
In a plan of sheer goodness.
Freely created man.
Freely created
man.
Man.
To make him.
To make him.
Share in his share, own blessed life.
Make him share in his own
blessed,
blessed life. So maybe we take the last part will be very good. God created us to make us share in his own
blessed
and happy life. Imagine, God created us with a great plan to make us share, to make us sharer in his divine nature, in his divine blessedness, in his holiness, in his wisdom, in his strength. And do you think, what do you think, what he the plan what with which he created, will he allow that plan be destroyed? That is why God will redeem us, that we are surely within with him, in union with him. That maybe God has created us to make us sharer in his own life, but we have got a freedom. Because of that freedom, we say, hello, Abba Father, I love you, but I want to be more free, bye-bye. And I want to go, I want to enjoy my life. I want to go to London, to France, to Paris, to New York. I want that freedom. So there, man's wisdom, his prudence should guide him, that freedom comes only from the Father. So people searching this joy, searching this happiness. Why people are searching the happiness? Do you want to be happy? Do you want to have a happy life? All of you? Sure. But how you got this idea of happiness? Very good. Give him a clap. Yes. God created us. While God creating us, he has installed a software inside us. What was that? A desire for happiness. Now, God is very prudent and wisdom. Why he made like that? Why he gave this desire of happiness inside us? Why? To seek him. To seek him. To seek happiness. So he gave the desire of happiness in us so that we become eager to have more and more and more and more and happiness. And in the search of that happiness, we initially went around and fallen into many pits. Suppose when a girl or boy said, I love you, I cannot live without you. Oh my God. Oh, great. What a great happiness. That night we could not sleep. We thought, yes, my life is fulfilled. Yes, that beautiful girl loves me. Oh, that beautiful and handsome boy loves me. Yes. There is a purpose in my life. And we were roaming around together, enjoying life, eating ice cream, one, two, or going for movie, or even what. One day, you happen to see this friend moving around with another girl. Ooh. A shock. Ooh.
I gave you all my life. What have you done to me?
Broken heart, no sleep, you don't want to go to school or college or no job, no, what is the lose, what is the sense of living now? Depressed, started complaining to all your friends, somebody started, oh, big beard, everything gone, the life is so bad, I never thought people are like this, So now we have learned that it is not, happiness is not coming from human origin. It's not from the human being. Or at that time we started searching a word of God to hang around instead of hanging on a rope. That's good. Then we were focusing on a word of God at the middle of the Bible, that is the center word of the Bible. What is the center word of the Bible? Psalm 118? 8. Very good. Come on. Please take that and read. Psalm 118:8. That's the center point in the Bible.
It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man.
It is better to trust and take refuge in God than
to trust in man.
To trust in man. So it was very costly. One had to spend a lot of time to learn this. So that is how every failure in our life teaches many things. So particularly in the desire of happiness, we have been searching. We thought that is the right real happiness. But then we recognize, no. That is not. Then from there we searching another idea of happiness. And our search will complete only when we will seek Him and find Him right within us. There, that's why Jesus says, seek first the kingdom of God. So kingdom of God is a fulfillment, is a happiness, a desire for happiness. Yes, God only can give us a happy life. Only God can give us a happy life. Of course, He will give you a right partner. All those things He will give us. So, it is the wisdom. If you are guided by the wisdom of God, you will be able to take up this route. Otherwise, we will be led by a human intelligence, going around and round and round in searching happiness in all the worldly pleasures, and finally you will find exhausted, deserted, totally down. But the Lord will not leave you. The Lord will hold you. The Lord will lead you. The Lord will keep on speaking to you. Go this way, further, further. Finally you will find it. In this happiness, we have to understand it is again not, the ultimate happiness is not a life in the earth. The ultimate happiness is a total union with the Holy Trinity, and that is called heaven. In Catechism of Catholic Church, paragraph 1024 gives us this explanation about the fullness of happiness. Heaven, the experience of heaven. So heaven is not a place beyond the clouds. It is the condition of our soul united with the most holy Trinity, the holy of holy of holy. Please read.
This perfect life with the most holy Trinity.
With the most holy Trinity.
This communion of life. And love with the Trinity. With the Virgin Mary.
The angels.
And all the saints is called heaven.
Heaven. Sometimes when I ask people, where is God? God is in heaven.
Yes.
So, that person will say, oh, I have been praying so many days, nothing is happening in my life. What is the use of believing in Jesus? Seek first the kingdom of God. So it was very good that somebody, his testimony that, yes, although we know the prayer to indwelling Trinity, the focusing on the kingdom, and that is the core of our faith. In every holy mass, in every prayer, before the prayer begins, we say, or the priest will proclaim, the Lord be with you. And also with you. So here we are focusing. I remember now a girl came to me with a lot of problems. I said, oh, your problems can be easily solved. You only have to pray. No, I have been praying every day so many hours, but nothing is happening. So I said, whom have you prayed? I prayed to God. And then I smiled at her and asked, where is God? Huh? You don't know? She said. You don't know this? God is everywhere. God is everywhere. I said, very true. That's why your prayers are not answered. See, the Bible, nowhere it is said in the Bible, you pray to a God who is everywhere. No. The Bible, it is said by some scholars, in 365 places it is written, do not be afraid. I am with you. I am with you. Our God is a personal God. The most holy Trinity is a person. Personally in us. And in that God there are three persons. Persons. And those persons combined together is God, and that God, yes, God may be everywhere. God is the creator. He is omnipotent, omniscient, omniscient, but more than all those experience or all those dwelling or reality or power, he is relating to our soul. He is dwelling, he is living in our soul. And when we discover this, and when we become an experience of that God within us, then is the fulfillment of our life. Fulfillment. That the time eternal, God who is eternal, united with my soul, making my life eternal. What is eternal? The ultimate happiness. The infinite happiness. But that begins now here. It begins here. It begins in our, while we are living in this earth, that God wants to show his holiness, his happiness, through human beings like us. Human beings like us. Sometimes, I remember now when I was in Bombay. What is this? Here? This is Bangalore. Okay. Sorry. In Bombay, those days when I was In business, I was doing some engineering business, and I had a lot of debt in the bank, a lot of money I had to pay to the bank. But nobody can understand from my face that I have such a big debt. I am always joyful, shining, smiling. So when I was visiting, I had some work in the bank. So I normally get the work done in the junior manager level, and I had nothing else to do with the manager. So I was sitting with him and chatting. Then a call came through the intercom. The manager saw me passing through. He said, yes, please ask Mr. Thomas Ball to meet me. Now this assistant manager said, see, the chief is calling you. Please go and meet him. Now, I had a lot of money to pay, so he may probably want to ask me, when are you going to pay? Some follow-up action. So then I was preparing in my mind what I should answer, what, etc. And I went to his cabin. He said, Mr. Thomas Paul, don't be upset. I have not called you to ask for money. I just want to chat with you. Please sit. Because you, in spite of all this debt, you seem to be very joyful. What is the secret of this? I gave another laugh. And I told him, his name was, I think, one Shetty, a non-Christian. I said, sir, you know, God is within us. Then I pulled out one of my visiting cards on which it is written, if God is for us, who can be against us? God is with us. There may be whatever may be the problems around us, nothing can harm us because God Himself is within us. He knows all our problems. He knows everything. So peace, joy is not an action of our life, but it is the presence of God in us. Peace, joy is not coming out from our actions, but it is coming out from the presence of God, who is the owner of this peace, who is the fountain of this peace, who is the origin of this joy. He is within us. And I started speaking about half an hour, a very good proclamation. Then he kept that card below his glass on the table, and he said, thank you, Mr. Thomas. It gives me a lot of comfort. So, reality of our life should be not focusing on our actions and our capabilities, but God's action in us. And that is what the kingdom of God. Seek first the kingdom. Rest all things will be added to you. So when we heard, and the first word we said was, Jesus said, truly, truly, I tell you, whoever believes in me will do all that I do and greater things. Because God Himself will dwell in us to activate us, to generate us, to become, to empower us, that so that we get such a great wisdom. Such a great wisdom. Actually, in the afternoon, I wanted to start talking about wisdom. But the Holy Spirit led in another way. Okay, now it's coming. Now it's coming. My dear, beloved, young brothers and sisters, you are all like my children. Because I have found out in this time, in this particular era, the biggest privilege we have is an access to the infinite wisdom of God. But somehow we never seek this wisdom, we never pray for wisdom, therefore our life is in struggle. I have seen many people, not only young, many grown-up people are in tremendous problems because of one foolish action taken place in their life. Because of one foolish action. Why? Because they never knew there is something called wisdom is available to us. God is love. God is mercy. God is compassion. Yes. But at the same time, God is also wisdom. God is wisdom. Everybody shout out, please. God is wisdom. Once again, God is wisdom. So, it's only through the wisdom of God our life can be successful. I told you once, maybe I may be repeating this many times, that only hard work alone will not make our life successful. We need to work hard with an idea from God. With an idea from God. We need to have a mission. A mission we can have only with a vision. First, you have to have a vision, an idea. Yes, 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 that's it. I have to do it. And this vision should come from God. That is the wisdom of God. Transmitting God's plan about you are especially each one of us. A plan God has. That has to be transmitted. That has to be downloaded into you, into your mind. That is the vision.